All right, guys, welcome to our dance talk. So we are so fortunate to have Max and Nico with us today. They're a very established amateur couple. So they've been dancing together pretty much forever, since they may be four. I have questions about that. And they're many, many times national finalists and winners from like a teddy bear category, probably. Three times rhythm national champions, representatives to the world, and just a very, very established amateur couple. How are you guys? Welcome.
We're good. It's really good to be here. Thank you for having us.
You see, you're like together. We're good. So you're dancing together since war. How many years is that already?
I think it's 15 right now. 15.
I guess one of my questions was, do you even remember having a tryout? Do you remember?
No.
It was never really a formal tryout. I think we just started going together and our parents just agreed for us.
And you guys stuck with it, huh?
Yeah.
I mean, I personally don't know any couple. I mean, I know couples that danced together for a long time, but they maybe got together as teenagers and continued their career.
My first partner.
But yeah, you danced
with me for 12 years as well. And we started the same way as you guys did.
Awesome. You see, you switched the partner. They still didn't.
Well, I have a little bit more experience in years ahead of them.
Right.
Talk all day. Right.
Yeah, my longest partnership was with Michael, 10 years. So you guys beat us all at this point.
I don't know. We were friends way before dance, like when we were kids. At our family.
You were like two?
yeah, we went to Russian school actually before dance together before that, and our friends and our family, and kind of at this point even our daily lives are so interconnected, I can't really imagine it any other way.
Okay, I'm gonna ask you something that I'm seeing. You obviously in the quarantine and you're at home, so you live together.
Well, we live together for the time being so that we can train.
Yeah.
Okay, so whose house are you in?
That would be mine.
That would be yours. I am super interested at what's happening on your wall.
The other side of the wall. Hold on. You haven't seen this side.
Okay. You're an artist. Hold on. Can you show us a little bit more?
Yeah. I make music. So I have like a microphone and like some keyboards.
I am so fascinated because
soundproofing.
Say it again and put it on your pictures because I want to see that.
All right. So wait, on these pictures or on?
Yeah, you have to talk. Okay.
So I make music. I don't know. I generally hang up stuff that kind of inspires me creatively. I don't know. It's a very different vibe and mood from the rest of my house a little bit. I don't know.
Because I used to make music and I recognized the soundproof. And that's what I was like, picked up right away. So what kind of music do you make?
I make like hip hop, R&B, I do pop. I don't know. I can do anything. I'm really good at writing. I'm like an English poetry type of guy. So that's what kind of drew me to music in the beginning.
Wow.
He's like multi-talented. He's also acting and does all the stuff. Triple threat.
Where can we hear any of your stuff?
I don't know. I post on YouTube a lot. I should be on Apple Music and Spotify and Google Play this summer.
Dude. So, yeah.
Good. And what's your musician name? Is it the same as it is?
So right now it's Mox. Right now it's Mox. M-O-X. And I made it that because it's a play to make people say my name the Russian way. So it's kind of like Mox. So it makes me feel, I guess, more comfortable.
Okay. All right. So it's a hidden talent that we didn't know about you.
Mm-hmm. It's something I'm working on the side. Dance is a priority right now for me.
Okay.
Right. I'll have a little inside information. Since I come in and coach them in New Jersey, I usually stay in his bedroom and get to stare at those pictures. And they actually, what is that? They're shiny when it's
nice. Yeah, they're like they're reflective. They reflect with UV light, so they like glow.
And it's really cool. So you go to sleep and then you still see all those colors. It's pretty awesome. Very like relaxing.
It is.
Since you said you're now at this point, you're pretty much always at their house anyway, but now you're kind of living there. Yeah. So how often do you still guys practice at this times?
We try to go every day.
Pretty much every day.
We pretty much go every day, depending on our online teaching schedule or on what classes we take online. But most of the time we go every day.
Usually we come to the studio, we teach like 3-4 online classes, and then while our coaches were quarantined, we took our own online classes with them and we used the studio space. So that was cool.
So now the question that I have is, who is your favorite coach?
Oh, it's like a team. It's like a team. I don't know. I feel, for me, Igers and Agatha were my team for the longest time. I guess they know me the best. They know how I respond and they kind of know me as a person. But right now, I feel like it's such a team. Liana is so big to my rhythm. You know, Igers and Agatha don't touch my rhythm. So as a product.
Yes.
As a product, I feel like right now, in rhythm especially, I have a bunch of different influences and favorites. But for Latin, it's Igers and Agatha as a team. I love them.
Nicole, what about you? Do you have any hidden talents?
Max, do I have
she
any?
She can sing.
Kind of.
She can sing. When I was really young, I used to make music and I used to have her sing for me.
So that was actually my question. Why don't you do it again? Or she just won't do it?
I think I will. She has a song that she really liked when we were 15.
Yeah, and I think that he should just
she
do
wants
it again.
To remake it with the older version of our voices. So I think we'll do that.
It doesn't sound so
great.
Oh,
you're going to put like your baby voices there?
No, I made the original song when I was like 14, 15. So it kind of sounds baby voices and we want to re-record it.
Now your voice is so much deeper.
So much more masculine.
Mine didn't change that much.
Well, girls grow up a little bit sooner as far as the voice's concerns and height.
Same at 14, 15.
So how do you structure your practices? Because we're asking this with everyone because everybody's different. I would love to know, because you're an accomplished couple, how do you structure your practice? Is it always the same? Is it something that you have as a secret weapon that you can share?
I think it depends day to day. We always start by like stretching. We warm up on our own because we always have to get into that headspace. Sometimes we watch videos of, you know, inspiration, just to from old times, from something newer, just to see, you know, something new.
And I don't know, I feel like our kind of, you said like secret weapon for practicing is the fact that it has been 15 years, so we really don't have any sorts of, I don't know, it's kind of hard to believe, but like arguments.
Yeah, we don't really,
disagreements. Or like minor scuffles in practice. We kind of are always on the same page.
I can kind of concur that. I never, guys, saw you even like having, not even an argument, but like even a heated discussion, you know? It's like, it's amazing.
I don't know. I feel like our coaches help with that a lot. And so did our parents, kind of the whole team aspect and kind of how we were raised. But like, for example, if she needs to take 1 hour, 2 hours to work on something that she wants to work on, I can respect that and vice versa.
So really the teamwork is a dream work.
Yes.
Yeah. Finding your correct team.
So Kiesha, just to give you a little history here. So do you remember that studio in Saddlebrook where you taught with Max?
Yes.
And I started dancing there and I started teaching there. That Russian school under, that's
yes.
What I was talking about.
Wow, the one that's pretty much built. My goodness.
So you maybe even possibly remember him. What year were you born?
2000.
Oh, okay, then probably not, because I remember
I was out, yeah.
Very little.
The generation that I thought it was Sergey.
I see, here you go. So
that
I came in, he was already there, and I remember Max coming in upstairs all the time, being super little. Giant fuzzy
afro,
red hair. Yeah, you were so funny when you were little. And then the other insights, Nyesha, that now they are the ones that own that studio upstairs. So that's where they are. Isn't that crazy?
This is like 3 generations.
Yeah.
Ouch, and I feel very old. The last time I felt this old is when Val came up to me, and a little bit to tell you, I've taught Val when he was 9. And he came up to me after Dancing with the Stars in one of the LA clubs, and he goes, "So what are you drinking?" And I was like, "Oh, I should not be in the same space with you."
I remember when Dasha was in that building too, when Dasha was there. It's crazy because now I get to teach kids in the same space that I was taught in when I was a kid. It's like very
I think that space is very magical. I truly believe that space magical. We even practiced in the roof. Have you guys practiced in the roof yet?
Definitely not done that yet, but I will make sure to try it.
I don't even know if there is access to the roof anymore.
No, there is.
Ooh, okay, well that's just something you can try.
And the good days, it's always good over the fresh air, you know, it gives inspiration.
So since we're talking about that, you guys now teaching at that studio, I personally started teaching back in Russia at age 15. So at what age did you start teaching?
Well, we started around like 13, 14 because we had this like moment in our career where we didn't really have like a studio. So we like rented out different spaces.
We rented out this crazy like plywood floor in a synagogue, and we had like 10 couples who didn't have a studio or a place to be. So we kind of ended up coaching and practicing ourselves there for like 6 to 8 months at least.
Yeah, so that we kind of just, you know, try to build a team around us just so that we have some kind of inspiration, or so we could be inspiration to little kids so that, you know, we can have that club feel.
And it's that period of time where we tried to make that team where it really became like a family studio. The coach in my studio who's responsible for syllabus choreography and like really working with kids is my older cousin. So my mom manages. I have my best friend who works with me and who is my partner. So it's kind of my little brother helps out and teaches kids now. So it's very
family oriented. So yeah, we always try to keep that
feel. They always had that feeling. Absolutely. Mm-hmm.
Since you mentioned your little pain in the ass brother, tell me, do you ever, or tell the audience, I guess, do you ever teach your brother? And if you do, how does it go? Because, I mean, that dude is super opinionated. Love him to death, though.
Before we used to try, I used to, like, I guess, teach him occasionally in a more structured way. And even my mom was a bit more for it. But recently I've gotten rid of that and just, I don't know, when we practice together, I can tell him something and look at something and I feel he respects it more that way because it's less of a structure around it.
Right.
I feel like when he feels that structure, he's a little backing away from that idea, but when it's less, he takes more from me.
How much of an age difference do you guys have?
3 years, so not that much.
3 years. Well, yeah, so it's like enough to be brothers, but enough to like still have that level of respect.
Yeah. Awesome. We're like friends. At this point, he's my size, right? He's like,
oh my God, I think he's already going to be taller.
No, for sure. Like 6 foot.
Nika, do you ever teach them?
I taught Dave and his old partner when they were younger, but I feel the same. If I'm asked a question, like how does this look or can this be styled better? I mean, I can always help out, but I feel like the same thing. If there's a structure around it, then it becomes like a little too, there's some little barrier of tension there. So sure. I try to.
The armor goes on and you have the warrior to protect
yourself.
I want to ask you guys, because you keep on mentioning this word, inspiring, right? I want to know who inspires you. Who was that person that you wanted to be like? Or still?
At what stage of my life?
Well, at this point, how about this? What dancers do you look up to?
Well, I look up to a lot of dancers, but I wouldn't necessarily put them as like, oh, I want to be exactly like them, because I feel like you have to have your own thing. Like, I take a lot of inspiration from Nino, as I'm sure a lot of girls do. I take inspiration from my coach, for sure. But I also don't want to be like a carbon copy, because then you're not able to inspire other people, so...
Yeah, I feel like dance-wise inspirations for me, I guess I have a lot. I think this couple, Pasha and Oksana, they're kind of an on-the-rise couple, is a big one for me. I don't know how many people are hardcore fans of them, but I don't know. I also get inspired by like people's character. And like, I don't know, when I used to dance, I was always a big performer, sometimes lacking on technique a little bit. So especially I feel like my personality type gets inspired by like performers and vibes and moods and kind of characters. That's why
having a world champion as Slavik and Daria would be something that it could be also inspiring, because I'm sorry, the
you mean Stefano and Daria?
Yeah, she changed.
Well, I mean, listen, they used to date, it's very easy to mess it up.
Well, now she's married to Stefano. Stefano is a big performer, and I'm super excited that the world champions at this moment.
Mm-hmm. No, but that's true. You said about performance and technique. I always like whenever I see you compete, and like every time I feel like you're not really doing your work, it's not because of technique now lacking. I literally come up and I'm like, can you please stop thinking and just do your thing?
I feel like experiences like that taught me that technique is something that's just like never ending, but there's also a time and a place to think about it. I feel like when you think about it at the event, like in Russian, there's this phrase, I feel like it's like that, like with technique, it's kind of pointless to push at competition.
Right, so if we're gonna translate for our listeners, you can't breathe enough before you die, something like that.
Yeah.
There will never be enough air before you die.
It will never be fulfilled.
Yes.
So do we want to do the quiz today?
You should do it. So
do the quiz quickly just so we don't run out of time. And I'm gonna ask you questions. You guys have to answer it very quick and be completely spontaneous. Okay, you ready?
Don't overthink.
As ready as I can be.
Describe yourself in three words. Go.
Spontaneous, extroverted, social. Go.
Realistic, outgoing, and crazy.
I love the crazy part.
I vouch.
One thing that people do that drives you absolutely crazy.
Chewing loudly, right away.
Complaining, blaming, sulking.
If you had to play a movie, what role would you like?
James Bond.
James
Bond. No, Austin Powers.
Oh,
I would be the boss in Devil Wears Prada.
Ooh, nice one.
Good choice.
If you can't sleep at night, what would you do?
Make myself a sandwich.
Listen to music until I fall asleep.
What are you afraid of?
Pigeons.
Loss of loved ones.
Well, that goes without saying.
I don't know. I'm not really scared of much.
What would be your dream vacation?
Bali.
Yeah, 100%.
I just came from there. It's the most beautiful place ever. Yes.
Yeah, at some point she's like, it was so good, I'm moving there. I'm like, no, you're not moving.
I don't know. Doing all the virtual lessons nowadays, maybe I will, but
I know, right?
If it picks up. Okay. If you had to wave a magic wand, what would you change about each other?
Nothing.
Nothing.
No magic wand needed.
No, maybe the height difference. That's
I was about to say that.
Maybe the height difference.
Bring her.
So you'll make yourself shorter and you'll make her taller, or
no, I'll make her a little taller. Tall.
But you won't make yourself shorter.
No. Okay. What is the most extreme thing you guys ever have done besides ballroom dancing?
Wow. I've done a lot of extreme things.
Give us few if you had so many.
Okay. I used to go to summer camp as a kid, and I lived on a second story floor. And at night, we used to have these people, counselors called dежурные, who would make sure that basically you would stay in your room. And I climbed off the balcony from the second story down to the ground floor so me and my friends can make a bonfire.
I lived on the first floor, so I just went.
My coach was actually in camp at the time, and he made me run laps for it. So that's why that memory is so fresh.
That is fun. That is so fun. Well, I'm sure you have plenty of time in your life to create more extreme things and enjoy yourselves.
Definitely.
At this point, your quiz is going to be over, but I do want to ask you one more question. How do you guys create, and this is just, I guess, for the viewers, how do you create a partnership that lasts besides the team? What do you do for each other that makes you stay together?
I honestly think that it's really about like family. We've always really been around each other. We always try to create this positive atmosphere between one another. If one of us is not vibing one day, the other one will try to bring them up, or vice versa. And if usually if we both have an off day, we both agree that we both have an off day, so there's no arguments and stuff like that. I don't know, we just kind of...
Did your family sign the contract?
I don't know. For me, it's multiple things. One is growth isn't always like individual. Like when you're frustrated and you're trying to change or grow, I don't think you should block others out or blame others. So I've never been like, I feel like it's always a teamwork type of aspect between each other. And I also think growth happens off the floor as much as it happens on the floor. Because if you two people are very in tune with each other in life, I feel like training and competing and getting through adrenaline rushes and nervous moments and mess ups at competitions, I feel it becomes easier.
Wow, that's a really profound answer. I love it. I'm like sitting here listening going
I think they're very mature for their age, and I'm super excited you invited them, Lena, because yeah. It got me a chance to actually get to know you guys. I've never met you in person, and I've watched your dancing, but I'm super, super, like, intrigued right now. Like, I don't even know what to say, and knowing that you're actually practicing in the same space when I won my nationals, I mean, I'm super excited. I feel like that space is magical, I hope you give many, many, you know, great advices and coach a lot of new generations in that place, because it's fantastic.
Yeah. Thank you, guys, question. Now that we still don't know when things are opening and what kind, like what are your kind of future plans? Are you planning anything, waiting on something? Like there's maybe other new projects you got involved with? What's in the future?
We're trying to find a way to have our camp still be a camp, because every year his mom organizes a huge dance camp, and we go to upstate New York, and it's like a sleepaway camp where we train all day nonstop. And when I mean all day nonstop, I mean we come back to the rooms and all we want to do is just knock out on the bed. So we're trying to keep that up.
The living situation.
Second floor to do a bonfire.
Of course. The living situation might have to be different. It might have to be more spread out. The occupancy might be limited, but I still want to have at least some people make that trip and still do that camp, even if it's for only 1 week, because I feel like that's what keeps me in shape every year during the summer. So.
Yeah.
Well, those trips are definitely really, I remember when my company, my mom owned the Dance Academy as well. We also traveled every summer for about a month and trained every single day. And those are the most memorable things about dancing. And it also creative things, because you're in a different atmosphere and it pushes you to really be a survivor.
Exactly. Friends push me the most. Friends who dance. That's why I love it too, because I get to be surrounded by competitors and people who are more level with me, who are also training. So it brings out the best in everyone, I feel like.
This is super great. Well, we are running out of time. I just wanted to remind my co-producer there. I'm super excited that I got a chance to meet you guys. And I'm hoping that we can have you back when things are a little bit more normal and watch you dance and maybe, you know, share a little bit more about your camp if it gets to be organized and have you live, you know, at some competition. I'm super excited. Thank you so much. And I definitely
can't wait until everything opens up so I can go back to the studio and kick your asses again.
For sure. I'm waiting for it. Thank you for having us, you guys.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for joining the Dance Talk. Thank you, guys.
All right. Bye.
Bye. Ciao. No.
When you kiss me, feel when you're